Dr. Shira Doron from Tufts Medical Center joins us now to answer more questions about the Omicron variant. Dr. Doron, this was the first confirmed case here in Massachusetts. It's now confirmed in more than a dozen states, and most experts said that it would spread. But are you surprised how quickly it spread?
No, I'm not. I mean, what we've learned about this virus is that it is incredibly contagious and it can't be contained. Air really doesn't know any boundaries. So not surprised to see it here. Not yet seeing signs that we need to panic about this new development. We have to see how it behaves compared to the Delta variant.
And Dr. Doron, Delta is still the dominant variant here in the U.S. What are some of the key differences between the two?
Well, you know, we don't know. We suspect that there could be some differences based on genetic information, but we really need to see how this variant behaves clinically in the real world. And so the concern is that it could be even more transmissible than Delta. We don't know that. The concern is that it could evade immunity from vaccines or prior infection. We don't know for sure about that either, but we don't think it will fully evade immunity from vaccines. We think the vaccines will still work at least to some extent. And we know that it doesn't evade the ability of tests to pick it up. So that's great. So we're waiting for more information.
And doctor, while this variant may in fact spread faster, as you mentioned, there are still a lot of questions about whether it may evade the vaccines. What, if anything, have we learned in this past week about how well it's going to perform against Omicron? Obviously, we know that there's a lot of information coming out of South Africa.
Yeah, I would say that what we have so far is anecdote, largely anecdote. There is a report from the South African Ministry of Health suggesting that they're seeing a lot of reinfection. So people with prior infection who are now infected with this variant more than was seen with the Delta variant or prior variants. I'm not sure, again, that that's going to be translatable to what we might see here in the United States. There's also been more time for people to get infected prior to this variant coming into play. And so with time, people become more and more susceptible to reinfection. So again, I think we really have to wait. Of course, the other question is severity. And we're hearing stories on both sides out of South Africa. Is the virus more mild? Is it more severe? We need to see tens of thousands or hundreds of thousands of infections before we can make any determination about differences in severity, because the vast majority of people actually do well with COVID. And so we don't want to fall prey to listening to individual stories or even individual hospital stories and think that that's going to be how it is for everybody.
And Dr. Doron, we're in the holiday season. Should we be doing anything differently right now?
Well, if you are not vaccinated, this is absolutely the time to be vaccinated. We don't know how this is going to play out, and we already have a Delta problem. We have cases steeply rising, and it is not safe to be unvaccinated at this time. If you are vaccinated and you're eligible for a booster, with this news, I've really shifted to encouraging people to consider strongly getting the booster at this time, particularly if they are older or have any medical problems whatsoever. And if you have done those things, I think it's still safe and important to gather with family and loved ones during the holidays.
Great advice, and thank you again, doctor, for your insight.
You're welcome.